Hello, singing friends. Welcome back to my channel. It's Miki here, your friendly neighborhood singing coach. I'm just looking at my hair in the camera right now. And I didn't brush it this morning and I look kind of like a wild woman, so I apologize for that. I'm filming this right after dropping my kids off at school in the morning and doing one lesson. So today I'm going to be doing a patron reaction request from James Pratt, and he asked me to look at an artist named Jackie Venson. So from her Wikipedia, she's an American singer, songwriter, and guitarist from Austin, Texas. She graduated from Berkeley in 2011, and she's released 3 studio albums, The Light in Me, Joy, and Vintage Machine. She also has released 3 live albums, Live at Strange Brew, Live in Texas, and Live at Austin City Limits. And she has a musical DJ alter ego that goes by the name Jackie the Robot and has released 2 albums titled Jackie the Robot Volume 1 and Volume 2. And they take her music and remix them to create a psychedelic electronic journey. So that's really cool. I love stuff like that. I've done an electronic album side project with my friends Dave Liang of Shanghai Restoration Project and Sean Han of the band Blip Blip Bleep, where we reimagined the character, the Cheshire Cat, in a series of songs on an album called Up the Rabbit Hole. And that was super fun and very out of my wheelhouse. So I always think it's really interesting and great things come out of taking these little side trips out of your main genre of music. Other interesting things about her biography, she comes from a very large family. She's the youngest of 9 siblings. Her father was a professional musician for 40 years and he really inspired her. And she admits that, you know, she started on the piano and it wasn't something that she took to right away. You know, most musicians are like, oh yeah, I started playing when I was 3 and I was really amazing and writing my own songs and it was just something that came so naturally. And she says that she really struggled with having the discipline to practice, but that having a professional musician father kept her motivated and showed her that it was possible. And she also mentions being at Berkeley and having it not match up to her fantasy and being very competitive and that she was really unhappy there. So I thought that those were 2 things that were really interesting about her biography. And then she was able to kind of discover freedom in playing when she picked up the guitar. And of course she used her piano and musical theory background to help her pick up a new instrument. Her genres are described as blues, soul, and pop. And when she records, she has a studio band of 3 musicians, but then when she performs, she uses a looping pedal to create various textures and sounds. So I haven't heard anything from her yet, but reading her biography really sparked an interest in me. It sounds really cool and exciting. So I'm really interested in checking it out. Before we jump in, all of my usual announcements. I'm gonna be pausing the video at least once so that I don't get flagged or blocked. But if you wanna watch the whole thing uninterrupted, I'll put the link down below, as well as how you can get in contact with me. If you wanna take any of my online courses, I'll put the link there. And I of course teach lessons one-on-one, either in person or in Zoom. So if that's something that you're interested in, you can check out my links down there as well. The first song that I'm gonna be checking out by her is Make Me Feel. And the lyrics are, and so now the story goes, I fall in love, floating free in outer space, I'm always falling. Day by day, I'm in the clouds, my faith is blinding, even though I know it's love, it still feels new. You make me feel so good, don't know what I'd do without you, you make me feel so good, and I never want to be without you in my life. There's a line that separates good from crazy. It's very fine, but I have learned how to navigate. I fell in love and I fell hard, so let it take me. Life is here for me to live, so I will live. And then it repeats the chorus. I don't care what they say, they will go theirs and I will go my way. I don't need to explain. I will not try to quantify. This is God's language and I will sing. I will spread love's comfort and healing. He has given his hand to me and I will do the same. Walk with him. I will do my best by him. I will not give up. Walk with him. Even in our darkest hours, I'll stand by his side, walk with him. Wow. So, you know, that was an interesting read, because initially when I started reading the lyrics, I thought it was about a personal romantic relationship, but actually I think that it's about her relationship to God and the divine. I love things like that, where you start out thinking that it's going in one direction and then it pivots and does a little unexpected side trip. So very cool lyrics. I really like them. They're just poetic enough. Definitely a style that I appreciate. Without further ado, let's check out Jackie Venson and her song, Make Me Feel.
How y'all doing? So I'm gonna give you guys a lowdown right now. I took every piece of every part of all my songs and I recorded them individually into this machine, and then I organized all of those pieces and parts into patterns, and I switched those patterns with my feet. So you're gonna see me tap dancing up here. But also, basically, if you're still confused, I'm in a band with myself. So we got Jackie Venson on drums, we got Jackie Venson on bass, we got Jackie Venson on rhythm guitar player. Every now and then, Jackie Venson on background vocals if she's feeling squirrely, you know what I'm saying? And my name's Jackie Venson, and this is Jackie Venson Band. This song's called Make Me Feel.
Just gonna pause it there before we really get into the meat of the song here. I love her already. I mean, she's so comfortable and she's got a great sense of humor and just stage presence. And then her speaking voice, I can tell that I'm gonna like her singing voice because she's got such a low, rich, deep speaking voice. And as you guys know, if you watch my channel, I love ladies with low voices. I just love that range in a woman's voice. And I can just tell that she's gonna be singing in my favorite register with all of my favorite warm, bassy tones. So I'm super excited now. So now the story goes, I'm all in love, floating free in outer space, I'm always moving, day by day I'm in the clouds, my mind is blinding, even though I know it's love, and love feels new. I love that riff. You make me feel. She's got a great pitch and great control. She's doing very complicated jumps and nailing all those pitches dead center. She's not doing a lot of ornaments, and I really like that because I think it exposes your sense of pitch. You know, when you're not dancing around the melody and you're just nailing those pitches dead center, you're not scooping up or down to the pitches or really doing a lot of like portamentos or anything, you can really hear that she's nailing those pitches. She started off and she almost had like this funkiness to her voice where she was doubling with the guitar. And I love that because it's like she's singing through the guitar, right? She's playing and singing the same notes. And That's the way that I think about improvising or soloing on the piano as well. I think, what notes would I sing? And a lot of times you don't see somebody doubling their voice with an instrument at the same time, and I think it sounds great. And then she went to the chorus where she was using more of that nice, rich, low register, and she's already displayed two parts of her register, right? That nice high, kind of like funky part, and then when she gets down into the more like bluesy soul kind of driven chorus, I love the message. It's very positive and it's very vibey and interesting. When she started, I did not know what to make of it. You know, it's got like some dancey elements to it. I like that it's a very simple drum beat. And on the chorus, she's doing little solo figures on the guitar in the spaces where she's not singing. So I think it's really great. I mean, it's amazing that she's playing everything herself. You know, as she says, this is the Jackie Venson band, and she's pre-programmed all of the different band instruments herself, and I think she did a great job with them. You know, she's not like a virtuosic, she's not displaying like very complicated drum patterns or anything, but I think it actually really works because the drum pattern is so nice and open that it really gives space for her vocal to breathe. So everything that she's done in all the various instruments sounds really competent and good, and then she's displaying her more virtuosic playing on the guitar. And her voice is beautiful and amazing. I was expecting more of like a smokiness from the description in her Wikipedia, but her voice is actually very clear. There's a lot of clarity and I don't hear any like rasp or anything like that, but she's got a beautiful, amazing voice, and this is a really interesting sound. Definitely very vibey. I love her guitar playing, and I thought those harmonies at the end were really great. It's a really nice play in contrast too. It is like a positive message, but the music itself doesn't sound that happy, you know? And I always love that combination, you know, when you have like sad music and happy lyrics, or happy music and sad lyrics. I think it's more interesting than doing both in one direction. It creates a nice tension. And yeah, I thought she's really inventive. I don't even know who I would compare her to. You know, maybe she's got like a little Prince in her, the way that she's singing in the beginning and the guitar playing. I thought it was really interesting, really, really cool artist. I even love her performance outfit, you know, her costume. I don't know what you would call it. It's really cool. The like the gold lame with the black feathers. It's really, really cool. It reminds me of like, you know, glam rock or something. So yeah, she's clearly very, very talented, very well musically educated, and combining that with technology in a really cool way. And all of this is, you know, it's coming unfiltered from her brain because it's just her, you know? So that's what's really fun about somebody that can kind of do everything and do the production and engineering as well. So I thought it was really cool. Thank you so much to James Pratt for the recommendation. I hope that you enjoyed my reaction. I'll see you guys here next time. Until then, take care. And of course, happy singing. Bye-bye.